For our model today, we will be applying a formal look. We'll be applying our 103 concealer all over the eye before we apply our eyeshadow. Now just blending in. Now taking third down, second to the left, we will be applying our eyeshadow all over the eye, starting with the inner of the eye to the outer portion of the eye. This is for a formal look, so we want to keep it classy and classic. Now taking our lightest brown complexion of our eyeshadow palette, we will be applying our eyeshadow in the fold of the crease of the eye to give it a little warmth. Now taking our concealer 103, we now will be applying the concealer under the eye using our concealer brush. Now we have applied the concealer under the eye using our concealer brush. Now we will proceed to use our foundation. Now proceeding to the next step, we will proceed to use 217 on our cream foundation, applying all over the face of the foundation. From our concealer palette, we now will be taking the yellow, applying it to the inner portion, bottom section of the eye. This is going to highlight on the cheekbone for a formal look. At this moment, we now will be using our AVAS Beauty Blender brush to blend in our yellow concealer. Starting from the inner portion of the eye, working the product, pressing it into the skin. Now using our top left-hand corner powder, we now will set the concealer with the powder brush. I'm just working the product into the skin at this moment. We just set the concealer under the eye so we don't have any wrinkles or fine lines throughout the day for long wear usage. Now we will be contouring the nose with the inner portion of our powder palette. With our same powder palette, we'll be taking under the same powder that we utilize at the bottom of our palette. In the middle, we will be working the product with our finger, taking the product. For this purpose, we use to contour the nose for a more slimming effect for our look today. Taking our powder brush, we want to run the product down the nose to blend in. For the cheeks today, we have chosen to use the bottom right-hand corner blush for pop on the apples of the cheeks. Now taking our lightest shade of our top left-hand corner, we now will be proceeding to apply the powder to the bottom of the contour to give definition and contrast. To mattify this look with our powder, we're going to use the inner portion of our powder palette on the top of the forehead. Also in the back portion of the cheek. This is for our formal look. Now using our 303 brow pencil, we will be applying it to the top portion of the eyebrow. It's formal, but evening. Now we are just basically now we're trying to achieve a full brow for our look today with our eyeshadow pencil. Now at this portion of our look, we will be just doing touch-ups to enhance our blush, applying the same blush as initially used on the apples of the cheek. Using the same powder as before for the bronzer, the middle top portion of our palette to make indentation of the cheekbone. Applying eyelashes at this stage of the makeup would give a little fullness to our eyelashes without having to apply mascara, just for fullness. Now we're applying false eyelashes to add fullness to our eyelid so we don't have to apply mascara to the top portion of our eyelid. False eyelashes also give a little fullness. Taking our AVAS Cosmetics liquid eyeliner, we want to start with the inner portion of the eye. Now at this moment, with the eyeliner, I just want to give a deep, set it, black wing liner. This will add a lot of fullness to the eyelid. Great for photos. And it'll make the eyeshadow stand out too as well. Give a deep setted look with the lashes. Now I'm going to apply at this moment our 106 gold eyeliner pencil at the bottom of the eye. Using our black 100 eyeliner pencil, we now will be applying it to the inner portion of the eye. Now we'll be applying our 101 pigment dust. On the cheeks. And also under the chin. This here is going to give a little iridescence, luminousness, to take a mattified look that we created to look not flat. This is good for going out, event, where you're going to have pictures. Want to have a nice, even complexion, skin tone, the little pop of the cheeks. Also apply on the forehead. Intense Berry 204 we now will be applying to our client's lip. This is a lip liner, waterproof, staining the lip. Now I can stain the lip with our lip pencil. We now will use the back portion of our pencil to move the product around for even distribution. This is good before you apply the lipstick. To finish staining the lip, leaving the inner portion of the lip free of the product, now to apply our lipstick. Now applying a wine color from our palette, third row down, first to the left. Previous Intense Berry color 204 is going to add warmth to the lip line while we apply this color. Drink some water. You won't have to worry about reapplying. Creases of the lip have been stained. Chin on the inner portion of the face. I'm just working the product in for a full application. Now you guys, for our next step, we will be applying the all-over face powder for a once-over to reduce any shine in the front of the eye where we had previously applied our concealer. Now it's going to be set with our face powder, starting with the inner portion of the eye. Bring the product out. working our all over face powder at the bottom of the face where we previously used our lighter powder. For our last step, today we will be applying eyeliner in the bottom of the eye and also as well mascara. Now using our AVAS mascara, we want to apply in light strokes under the eye just to add fullness to the bottom lashes. Now we are finished with our look. My name is Valentino and this is Jana. You can find me on Facebook at Valentino Ideal.
Hi, my name is Yana. You can find me on Facebook at Yana Darling or on Instagram at Yana Darling _XO. Today, Valentino helped me achieve this formal look. I wore this to prom, maybe a ball or even a late night dinner. I love this look. I'm so excited to go ahead and wear it out.